together with the Bureau of Development Services and Portland Development Commission, we've been working on policies to require the upgrades of some of the city's most beautiful historic buildings, otherwise known as unreinforced masonry, or URM, buildings. These important buildings add to the historic fabric of our city, but unless these buildings are upgraded, they pose a major risk to life safety after an earthquake. Earthquakes around the world, including Christchurch, New Zealand, Napa, California, and even here locally in the Puget Sound, confirm that these buildings are the most likely to sustain significant damage, including collapse, even after a moderate earthquake. I want to introduce you to Reed Zimmerman, a structural engineer in Portland, to tell you more.
What we see generally happening is the part of the wall that extends up above the roof line. It tends to fall either out away from the building or into the building. When it falls out away from the building, that part of the wall that extends above is called the parapet. When it falls away from the building, it'll fall onto the sidewalk where people might be. When it falls into the building, sometimes it will come through the roof and endanger the occupants of the structure. We also tend to see the walls of the building disconnecting from the floors and falling, typically out of plane. We call it an out of plane failure, again, into the street or into the structure.
How can you tell if a building is unreinforced masonry? Well, there are some telltale signs. Typically, these buildings were built in the late 1800s to early 1900s. They're typically made of brick and stone, and many of them have decorative parapets.
Classic signs of an unreinforced masonry building, especially red brick masonry building like we're seeing here, are these header courses. So here's the brick, that's sort of the long face of the brick, and here's the short end of the brick. So these courses, they've taken this header course where they've taken the brick and they've turned it sideways. So there's multiple Ys of this brick through the thickness. This brick is tying those Ys together. Kind of like growth rings on a tree, you can count these. So here's a single header course. If we count to 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, there's the next header course.
But not all brick buildings are URMs. Sometimes it's just hard to tell. Here's Reed outside a new building with a brick veneer.
So what you'll see is both the brick and the mortar bed are both unweathered. So in the previous building, the unreinforced masonry building, you saw rounding of the corners of the brick and probably weathering of the mortar bed. Here on these brick veneer buildings, that's not the case. Often also you'll see these weep holes where any water that gets in behind the brick veneer has access to come out.
Now let's hear from Walt McMonies. He owns one of Northwest Portland's most historic and beautiful residential properties, Trinity Place Apartments.
It is unfortunately unreinforced masonry, so we now realize that this beautiful building may not be here after one of those earthquakes, and that has various implications. It means it's unsafe for tenants in an earthquake. It's the beautiful aesthetics of the building would be destroyed. And in the interim, we can't be assured that we can refinance the building or get insurance to cover damage to the building. I feel you have a moral responsibility and possibly a legal responsibility to protect your tenants. You certainly need to notify them of danger, and if at all possible, you need to prevent them being injured by that dangerous condition.
It's clear, retrofitting these buildings will save lives in an earthquake. To find out whether you live or work in an unreinforced masonry building, visit the Bureau of Development Services URM database.